Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we are exploring Obduction. Oh boy, this game, first of all, for those of you who don't know, it's made by Cyan Worlds, the same people who made Myst. This game was funded on Kickstarter by them a while back. I think they started their Kickstarter in like 2012 or something, or maybe 2013, whatever. I heard about it back when it was first announced, but to be honest, I'm always pretty, like, cautious and, kind of skeptical about Kickstarter stuff. It tends to not turn out to be what you imagine it to be, and more importantly, they always take a really freaking long time to come out. And I seem to remember hearing some news about Obduction having some kind of development issues when it was being made, that, like, delayed it or something like that. So I just kind of generally didn't pay attention to the production of Obduction, haha. But turns out it suddenly released this week, or at the time you're watching this video, last week. I completely missed any pre-announcements of its impending release, but it's suddenly here on us, and so I'm gonna play it now because holy shit, I am actually genuinely super excited for this game. The screenshots and words written that I've seen about it make it sound like a pretty damn good follow-up, is the right word, to the Myst series. Speaking of which, the previous playthrough that I did of Myst on my channel was actually one of the most fun games that I've played through on my channel ever. Like that, and I think Fallout 3 so far are the most, the best experiences for me having on this channel. And I wanted to play Riven as well, the sequel to Myst that many of you probably know about. But unfortunately, it's basically impossible for me to record or upload videos of Riven at all because there's various issues with the software recording side of it that would make it very hard. But on top of that, the game crashes constantly because I'm running on a Windows 7 operating system and I have a multi-core processor, and some old games don't work well with either of those things, and Riven's one of those games. Even going through the various methods that I looked up online to try to get it to work, it still crashes, and it crashes pretty consistently after about, like, 10 minutes of playing constantly. I have played through it, and I've finished it, and it was pretty incredible, but I would not be able to record that comfortably because if for no other reason than just the fact that it would be crashing constantly and it would be an editing nightmare. So unfortunately for now, I can't play Riven on my channel. I hope this will suffice, and I also hope that the music in the intro for this video will suffice. That is the song titled Temple from the Riven soundtrack. I think all the Myst games have really awesome soundtracks, and that one's particularly pretty good. I searched around to find a good one, and there you go. Hope you enjoyed it. Okay, what's the other thing I want to talk about before we get started? Oh, yeah. Just wanted to mention real quick. Gonna do the total biscuit thing here and look at the settings. The game, thankfully, does have, you know, it's well done, or whatever. I don't fucking know what to call it. I can play it pretty much on maximum settings, except you'll notice anti-aliasing is down, because anti-aliasing on low makes everything look like horrible, jaggy messes of just horrible shit, especially the grass. But anything higher than medium makes it look like Vaseline is smudged all over the screen, because I guess they use the FXAA method of anti-aliasing. I believe that's the one that does that. I don't know, I'm not an expert, but the main thing I wanted to mention is that I do get a very solid frame rate, even with the highest settings, but unfortunately the game still, in the short little testing I did, it still does seem to hitch up every once in a while and sort of freeze for half a second, and it doesn't do that constantly, but it just does it every once in a while, so that's just, you know, wanted to explain that. It might not be super pleasant when that happens, but hopefully you guys won't mind. And also, in particular, the game has a camera function to let you take pictures in place of taking notes. And whenever you try to take a picture, the game, like, goes just dead. Just the frame rate drops to, like, sub-20 and stays that way for, like, a couple seconds. So I'm going to be avoiding using the camera. Instead, I'll have my trusty, busty little notebook here to just write notes the old classic frickin' fashion way. So with all that introduction out of the way, 5 minutes of me rambling, six nearly minutes of me rambling on, and I'm sure many of you have turned off by now, whatever, I don't care. This is basically a passion project for me at this point. Let's start it up. We'll just name the game Echo, because that's what I do. Free roam, character shadow off, because we don't want to be distracted. So let's start it up. There you go. Not super long load times, but good enough.
We all lost everything. Everything but our stories. And they shouldn't be forgotten. I was 3. It was April of 1983. Cecil, it was 1870 for you. Sam and Vera, you tell it like it was yesterday, but it's been 62 years since you saw that blast of light.
Yeah, this is one of the few games where I can actually bother putting the post-processing effects all the way up, because they don't hit the frame rate super hard. And, oh my god, that lighting. Do you see that lighting? Oh my god. I'm sorry, I'm a bit of a sucker for games with it. I don't care about the graphical fidelity of games. What I like is the, you know, when the art style and everything comes together to make it look really impressive. That's what I'm a sucker for. Use only designated campfire pits. Yeah, so we're at some, like,
light. That's where all of our new stories began. It streaked across the sky. Mesmerizing. But unnerving. Even in daylight, Joseph, you said it was gloriously bright. But in the twilight, it was spellbinding. Whether it was in the deep woods like Cecil, or right outside town like Jane and Jenny, we were drawn to see more. Here, you said you were all smiling. Some of you were alone. I wasn't. My dear grandma, God bless her, rejoiced as if some forebearer of good fortune. Grandma lifted me from the carriage on the porch and walked into the yard so we could watch it unobstructed. None of us understood it, but, well, we followed, and we all felt some kind of trepidation, yet attraction. So we approached it.
Okay. So, right now it seems...
You all remember.
Oh, shit.
There was no turning away. It advanced. Almost like... purposefully. Spinning. Slowly until... well... found us, each of us. We should tell these stories because... it saved us and...
So yeah, as I was about to say, we basically just sort of retraced the steps of the lady telling the story there. Also, listen to that music. That's what I'm talking about. Oh yeah. Alright. Cool, now we're in a cave. So it looks like we're near the same area, though. Campground equipment here. Yeah, I will, at certain points when the, when the talking dies down and the music kicks up, I will be shutting my own mouth and putting up that volume so you guys can listen to some of the amazing music in this game. I've only heard a little snippet of it myself when I was testing, but if what I've already heard is good and very reminiscent of the first Myst game and Riven as well. So, yeah, I want you guys to be able to appreciate that. Okay. Lamp. Awesome, we turned it on. I don't think we really need to turn it on. Can't take it with us? Maybe we do need to turn it on, but I don't know. No. Okay, pick that up. Need to stop right-clicking. Anything on the bottom? Nope. Alright. Map sensitivity is a little bit high. I might want to turn that down. Alright. We can't seem to take it with us. I highly doubt that it's going to run out of lantern oil, so I'll just turn it on and leave it there. Don't know if that's actually important for a puzzle or not. Oh, hey, there's the pod thing, the obduction pod. Alright, cool. That's also what's that little ball there with the green that was in the middle of it. It's gone now, apparently. That's what's on the cover for the game. That makes up the obduction logo. Again, pretty reminiscent of the cage sort of city village thing. The big ball that appears on the Riven logo. Of course. Yep, there you go. Of course, a lot of stuff in this game will be reminiscent of the earlier Myst games, and that's what I'm hoping for, because holy crap. To say how important that game was to me would be an understatement. If you watch my Myst playthrough, you'll hear a bit of an explanation of it. Okay. Now, what is this? Welcome to Hunrath. Okay. Calm down. Calm down for a second. I need to look around, because we're clearly not on Earth anymore. We got floating rocks and stuff in the sky. Though I don't know if we actually started on Earth. I assume we did. I assume that's what this game's all about, is that your character was on Earth and got abducted by that little pod thing here. And as the lady, the narrator, said, it saved us, somehow.
Hello. Bonjour. Ciao. Hola. Hello. Shora. Ni hao. Welcome to Hunrath. My name is Yosef. I am the mayor here. You are most probably a bit confused and disoriented, but let me reassure you, everything will be fine. You're not the first to go through this experience. The others who have come before you will help you adjust. Follow the trail to the house with the white picket fence. Fali will meet you there and introduce you to your new life here.
Okay. I have a sneaking suspicion Fali won't meet us there. I think this game is very much a solitary experience. But also, that's cool. They've got a... That was a real-life actor there. Doing a little FMV cutscene talky bit to us. That's very cool. I wasn't expecting the game to have those. Alright. Oh, shit. He wants us to go to the house, but there's already other paths. And we do have a sprint button. I'm just going to take a look real quick and see what's up here. A little glow bug. That's what's up here. Going towards... Oh, damn! It keeps going! Oh, wait. No, it doesn't. There's like a glass wall there, isn't there? Oh, cool. I was expecting it to be locked. Alright. What's up here? Oh, no. The game's hitching again. Stop. Oh, what is wrong with those rocks? I'm gonna assume that's intentional. Because it's not happening to any of the other rocks. There's like a weird shimmer effect over them. That's weird. I know the game does have an optional mechanic in place where it makes objects that you can interact with glow slightly, but I believe I have that turned off. If that is what it is and it's accidentally turned on, that is a huge no-no. Gonna want to turn that off if it isn't already, but I'll check after recording this episode because I don't want to have to stop in the middle of it. Okay, so yeah, there's a big glass wall here. What the hell? It's like a completely different biome over there. Oh, and it's making a noise when I touch it. Yeah. Jeez. Yeah, it's like a completely different biome over there, and it's like hard locked behind this dome, I guess. Oh, and a laser coming out of the sky. Okay, cool. Yeah, let's just like freaking view every single major landmark in this area. Jeez. Okay, there's a lot going on. A lot more than I expected. The game's like opening up right away with a lot of different stuff. I mean, that could not even be important, but I have a feeling that's coming from another area, and it's probably going to be somewhat important. Oh, no, it's... Oh, stop doing that, please. Don't hang up on me. There's some more of the rocks with the shimmering effect. You know what? Let me just do this real quick. There's... wait, no. General. Sorry. Whoops. General interaction guides off. Okay. Nope, still doing it. Is interaction guides... Is that, when the cursor shows the circle in the middle? Nope. Still does it even with that off. That is off, right? Yep, stayed off. Okay. I don't know then. I don't know what's causing that weird shimmering effect. Maybe those rocks aren't really there. Maybe they're holograms or something? I don't know. But oh boy, I think the running makes the hitching worse. Yeah, the game needs a bit of a patch. Hey, Glowbug! What's up, Glowbug? You running off to the house? Okay. I'll go to the house. I'll go to it eventually, but oh geez. Okay, yeah, that's a whole other area. Wow. Oh boy. Okay. Cool. Let's go to the house. Let's go to the house right now. Oh geez. Yeah, it's hitching a lot now. Because we're in this bigger area, I'll bet. Oh, there's another hologram doohickey here. Farley's Community Center. Alright. What do you got to say, Farley?
I'm Farley. I guess if you're seeing this, then I wasn't even... Just in case. Welcome, buddy. It's probably not safe here. To be blunt, we're getting ready for a battle. I don't know what you'll find. I just thought I should. Just be cautious with who you trust. CW may be here. I don't know. Just be careful. I've got to go.
See you soon. And don't panic. As jarring as this experience is, you really will find Hunrath to be a decent place.
Okay, so that was the same voice as the old lady who was narrating the opening. So that is Farley. Farley was the narrator. Okay, cool. Nice to know that. And CW seems to be the main antagonist of the game. Seems to be this game's version of Geth. If I was to guess correctly. Ooh, graves. And hitching. Really bad hitching, damn it. Maybe I should turn the settings down after this episode just to, but it looks so pretty. Probably should turn the settings down just in case that'll help with the hitching. I don't know. Anyway, can't crouch. Cursor mode unlocked. Oh, cool, we can do this. So that when we right-click, it's, free, like in the other games. Okay, I tried pressing C to crouch, just in case. Now control, neither of those working. Okay, so I can't really read that. I think it reads Daniel Harthen, or Harther? Anna Jackson. Margaret Hartnell. Okay. One's blank. Benjamin Sims. And Merlot Hartnell? I think that's Merlot Hartnell. Or Mara J. Hartnell? Not sure. Point is, there's definitely two people with the last names Hartnell on here. Kind of weird that they're not buried together. They're probably related. And actually, this one, Daniel Hartnell, that's probably his last name, Hartnell. So, yeah. Probably nothing super important, but it is a little weird that the Hartnells wouldn't be buried together. Whether any of them were married, or if one of them was a child, or even if they were all just family, doesn't matter. Usually, in any of those cases, they would be buried next to each other. Oh, look at this puzzle piece. Look at this frickin'... There you go. Alright, you know what? Actually, let's lock the cursor back up. This is actually a bit more smooth doing it this way. But, obviously at some point we're going to be bringing through a, probably from over there, I guess. We're going to be bringing through a minecart. Have to redirect it. Okay, cool. Let's check the mailbox. Maybe there's something in here. There's totally something in here. Alright. To Carolyn, or whomever else might come back. It has been 5 days, not a soul has returned. I am inclined to believe that things have not gone well. Yet, surprisingly, I am still alive, and that both supremely perplexes me and gives us some portion of hope. I have retreated to my vault for protection and to contemplate my options. CW. Okay. So, CW was who Farley talked about, and she talked about him as if he was the bad guy. And apparently he's friends with somebody named Carolyn? So I guess if we meet Carolyn, watch the fuck out. I can't see inside the house. But can we go inside the house? Warning, do not approach anything that even remotely resembles this diagram unless it has been disabled. Okay. Sure. Oh, damn it, the frame rate. Yeah. Guess it was too much to hope for. Oh, that's locked. Too much to hope for that the game would run nice and smoothly. With the hitching problems that it was having. Guess it was a little worse than it first had appeared when I tried it out. Oh well. Damn, this house is... Is this the same thing, like, with what happened with the glass dome? Oh, holy crap, yeah. Look at this. The ground. So this whole, this whole house was sitting somewhere, probably on Earth, with a nice little green lawn around it, and it got super frickin' abducted. And a bit of the street out in front of it, too. Just, like, straight up picked up by some really powerful alien tractor beam type thing, and then plopped down right here. And they carved out a little bit of the rock to put it here. And it's in, like, a perfect circle. Or almost perfect. course, some of the dirt has fallen away in certain places, and it's not exactly even, but close enough. Holy crap. Alright. Hey, you again. Yeah. Nothing else we can do with you. Or you. Alright. So, we have no instructions on what to do. Farley simply told us to watch out for CW. And we know to avoid, the soccer ball of death, which I should probably take a quick little sketch of myself. Not an artist, but, you know, I can get the rough shapes down. There you go. Ooh, and it has, like, little divots in it. Like that, basically. Pretty much. Yep. Totally looks nothing like the diagram in the game, but it's got the basic shape down, so I'll remember it. I'll remember it for what it is. Alright, let's check out behind the house. This area seems like a dead end. Okay. Cool. Never mind. Is that train tracks up there? Or just a walkway? Looks like just a walkway. But that steel girder there resembles a train track. I swear to God, if this game doesn't have a moment where you can get inside a big ball that rolls around on some tracks and just roll away and use that to travel to a different area, I'm gonna be mad. Oh, hey! There's a blinking light there. Like, right there in the middle of the screen. Got it circled with the cursor now. Seems to only be blinking when we're moving, so it's probably just an object that's reflecting some light. Actually, I just realized this doesn't seem to actually be moving the tracks. Do these not have power or something? Of course they wouldn't have power. Of course not. Okay, actually, hold up. If we're bringing it from that way, would having the lever pointed over here stop it from going past this point? And I guess we should have it pointed this way, so if the cart is coming from that way, then it would go down there, and then we turn it this way to send it down there? Maybe. I'm not sure. We'll find out. And now we've got a whole town to explore. Hartnell Mining Co. Alright. Oh, there's another little hologram thingy, or a FMV person will talk to us. Hartnell Mercantile. Oh my god, is this a, is this like a legitimate, like, old-timey American Wild West type town from the settling days? Because that seems to be the theme that we're going with, where the actual planet we're on, the natural landscape of it is those blue, like, mountainous regions in the background you see there. But it seems that the aliens that went around abducting people put this little dome down, and for most of it, it seems like they went and picked up an old mining town from the days of, you know, settling America, and plopped it down here, and then just sort of right on top of that, they fit that the little house down. Okay. Oh, it's one of the hologram thingies that's reflecting light so brightly. Alright, downtown Hunrath. Alright, what you got to tell us?
We have a healthy, thriving community here, as you can see. Our garden was planted years ago and has supplied plenty of food for many generations. The buildings around town serve multiple purposes, including housing, schooling, and storage. I'm sure you have run across a number of folks already. Many were brought here, like you, and some actually were born here. We all feel we are part of the whole.
He seems really optimistic, that Yosef guy. And I haven't seen a single person. And according to Farley, they were getting ready for a battle at some point against CW. So, yeah. Either Yosef's completely talking shit, or these are really old recordings. One or another. But unfortunately, that is all the time I have for now. I'm going to have to end the episode here. I hope you all have enjoyed this, and I hope you will continue to enjoy it as I keep going. I'm definitely going to play through this entire game, even if it kills me. So I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.